Cek. Bismillah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi.
So, alhamdulillah guys, this afternoon we can meet again and do pray zuhur with Allah's gift. So, we can meet yang in the place that inshallah blessed by Allah Subhanahu wa taala. And salat and salam always be given to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. With his guidance, we can get the ni'mah of Islam, iman, and with his So just straight to the point. So I don't know if this is my schedule, but Mr. Ben, is it mine?
It should be done last week before you leave.
Yeah. So alhamdulillah, I can meet you guys again after 2 weeks. I cannot active in this area because I got sick, I got ill, and the second week I have to teach at Purwokerto. So today I would like to just say some maybe that I get from this, last time opportunities to teach at Purwokerto. So maybe guys, being friendly, it's not always that bad. Because when I teach at Purwokerto, one of the students said to me that to keep smile. So she said that she said to me that please to keep friendly to us when you teach us. I don't know why I get that command, when because honestly me, Faki and Afta, it's we are that we try to perform at our best, and but so I accept this for my self improvement to it's one of the sunnah, right? So it's not a challenge, it's not an obstacle, or it's not a problem when you guys smile every time, because smile it's sunnah in every condition, when you are depressed, when you are get in trouble, because sometimes your worst condition, it can be make someone get a better mood with smile, and sometimes it can make you when you smile to the other people and he give a good feedback, sometimes it can make our mood is better than before. So that's the hikmah, the lessons that I got about smile from the last opportunities. So maybe that's all I can to say, but and don't forget to stay smart, smile sunnah. So assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you for the speech, Fadil. Now we go back to Palian. Please come forward. Yes. Okay.
Bismillah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'du. First of all, let's pray and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has been giving us some mercies and blessings so that we can attend in this mosque and pray Dhuhr without any obstacles at all. Secondly, salawat and salam to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that has guided Islam from the Jahiliyah era to the Islamiyah era and the Islamic religion that we love. So in here, I want to deliver a topic about maybe two hadiths, and both of them are about fasting. The first is about fasting in the month of Ramadan and Shawwal. The hadith goes, "Man soma Ramadana thumma asbaha sitta min Shawwal kana kasyamita." So the meaning is, whoever fast in the month of Ramadan and then 6 days in the month of Shawwal, then he will get a reward that is like fasting 1 year. So from this hadith, if we can get the conclusion that if we fast in the month of Ramadan full 30 days, then we fast 6 days in the month of Shawwal, then we will get a reward, an extra reward that is like fasting 1 year full. Then the second hadith is about the sin that you can get when you are fasting. So the hadith goes, "Man lam yada' qawla zuhri wal a'mala bihi fa laysa lillah hajatun fi an yada' ta'amah wa sharabah." So the meaning from that hadith is whoever didn't leaves lying, and then he actually did it when he is still fasting, then Allah doesn't need his fasting. So the conclusion from this hadith is actually, if you are still lying when you are fasting in the month of Ramadan or in other months of Ramadan, like fasting sunnah or other fasting, and you are lying, then Allah doesn't need your hard work that you did when you are fasting. Allah doesn't need your hard work or your at that time hold your hunger and thirst, and yeah, Allah doesn't need all of that. Many minutes. And yeah, so the conclusion is, if you are in the condition of fasting, then you don't need you don't need to do any sin, and yeah, it's very recommended to do the 6 days in Shawwal month. Okay, maybe that's all for me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you Valian for the speech. So that's all for today, and for tomorrow is just Tio, please prepare for tomorrow. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.